Dear members, guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon to all of you. Before we start the formal proceedings of the meeting, we would like to play national anthem in the honor of our great nation. It is indeed a great honor and privilege for me to extend a very hearty and warm welcome to each one of you at the 47th Annual General Meeting of the company. I would like to convey my sincere gratitude to all of you for sparing your valuable time and joining the 47th Annual General Meeting of the company through video conferencing or other audio visual means. Let me introduce myself. I am Ashok Jha, Company Secretary of the company. In view of current ongoing pandemic and in compliance with the circulars issued by Ministry of Corporate Affairs and Securities and Exchange Board of India, this meeting is being conducted through video conferencing or other audio visual means without the physical presence of members at a common venue. For conducting the AGM smoothly, I would like to highlight certain points here. The joining to this meeting has been opened 30 minutes prior to the scheduled time of the meeting, that is 2:30 p.m. and window for joining the meeting shall be kept open till the expiry of 15 minutes after the scheduled time of AGM. As mentioned in the notice, the facility of participation at the AGM through video conferencing or other audiovisual means has been made available for 1,000 members on first-come, first-served basis. This will not include promoters, institutional investors, large members, directors, key managerial personnel, chairpersons of the audit committee, nomination and remuneration committee, and stakeholders relationship committee and auditors who are allowed to attend the AGM without restriction on account of first come first served basis. Members who have casted their vote through remote e-voting, which was made available from 9 a.m. on Sunday 26 September 2021 and ended at 5 p.m. on Tuesday 28 September 2021 shall not be entitled to cast their vote again. Only those members who have not cast their vote through remote voting and are present in the AGM through video conferencing or other audio visual means shall be eligible to vote through e-voting at the AGM. Members are encouraged to participate through their desktops or laptops with high-speed internet connectivity. Please note that participants connecting from mobile devices or tablets or through laptops via mobile hotspot may experience audio or video loss due to fluctuation in their respective networks. It is therefore recommended to use a stable Wi-Fi or LAN connection to mitigate any of the aforementioned glitches. All members who have joined this meeting are placed on mute mode by default to avoid any disturbance from background for ensuring the smooth conduct of this meeting. I would like to introduce the chairman, directors, and other dignitaries sitting on the dais to you. Sri Nilesh Singh Rai, Chairman and Managing Director of the company.
Namaskar.
He is BE in Instrumentation and Control from Thapar University. Prior to his appointment as Chairman and Managing Director, he was holding the position of Director Technical in NFL. He had also held the position of Chief Executive Officer at Ramagundam Fertilizer and Chemicals Limited, and he had also headed the Nangal unit of NFL as Chief General Manager. He has a rich experience of more than 3.5 decades in technical services and operation and maintenance of large scale of fertilizer plants. He is member of Audit Committee, Nomination and Remuneration Committee, Corporate Social Responsibility and Sustainable Development Committee, Stakeholders Relationship Committee, and Risk Management Committee of the company. He has been nominated as Director on the Board of Fertilizer Association of India. He is the Chairman of Ramagundam Fertilizers and Chemicals Limited. Sri Viren Nadar, Director Marketing of the company. He is an MBA having a rich marketing experience of over 34 years in oil and natural gas industry in India. Prior to NFL, Sri Dutt was Executive Director, Corporate Strategy, Planning and Advocacy with Gale India Limited. He was also on the board of Mahanagar Gas Limited, Mumbai. He is the member of Audit Committee, Corporate Social Responsibility and Sustainable Development Committee and Risk Management Committee of the company. Sri Yashpal Bhola, Director of Finance and CFO of the company.
Namaskar.
He is an MBA Finance and member of the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. He has rich experience of more than 3.5 decades handling various functional areas in Finance and Accounts Department at UNITS, Central Marketing Office, and Corporate Office of the company. He is member of Stakeholders Relationship Committee, Risk Management Committee, and Corporate Social Responsibility and Sustainable Development Committee of the company. He is the nominee director of NFL on the board of Urvarak Videsh Limited and Ramagundam Fertilizers and Chemicals Limited. Sri Pandya Ashwin Kumar Balwantre, Independent Director.
Namaskar.
He is an independent director of the company. He is M.Tech from IIT Delhi and is serving as chairperson of International Commission on Irrigation and Drainage. He is the chairperson of Audit Committee, Stakeholders Relationship Committee, Risk Management Committee, Corporate Social Responsibility and Sustainable Development Committee and Nomination Remuneration Committee of the company. I wish to inform that Sri Dharampal and Sri Partha Sathy Sen Sharma, government nominee directors, are unable to attend today's AGM because of their preoccupation with other works. Sri Anil Fulwari, representative of President of India, is very much here with us. We welcome you, sir.
Namaskar.
The representative of Messrs. Mehra Goyal and Company and Messrs. Arun K. Agarwal and Associates, Joint Statutory Auditors. Sri Praveen Rastogi of Messrs. Praveen Rastogi and Company, Secretarial Auditor. Sri Pramod Kothari of Messrs. Pramod Kothari and Company, Scrutinizer. For remote e-voting and e-voting at this AGM have joined us through video conferencing. We welcome you all, sir. Mangla ji, please confirm the number of members attending this AGM through video conferencing or other audio visual means.
At present, 35 members has joined the meeting.
Thank you. We have the requisite quorum present through video conferencing to conduct the proceedings of this meeting. Participation of members through video conferencing is being required for the purpose of quorum as per the articles of association of the company read with circulars issued by MCA and section 103 of the Companies Act 2013. Now I request the chairman to call the meeting to order.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you all to this 47th annual general meeting of the company. Company secretary has confirmed that quorum for the meeting is present, and I call the meeting to order.
Now I request the chairman to deliver his address to the shareholders.
Dear shareholders, I have great pleasure in welcoming you to the 47th annual general meeting of the company. Board's report and the audited financial statements for the year ended 31st March 2021, along with auditor's report and comments of CNAG, have been with you for quite some time now, and with your permission, I take them as read. Before I proceed to take up the formal agenda of today's meeting, I would like to share with you in brief the economic and industry scenario under which the company is operating, challenges faced, performance of the company during the year 2021, and some of the ongoing activities. With the dedicated effort of the employees, your company remained immune to the COVID-19 pandemic triggered lockdown in the country, except some minor disruptions in the initial period of the lockdown. Moreover, timely action initiated by the industry in collaboration with central and state governments and local district authorities helped to keep all the urea plants in the country running, along with movement of the fertilizers, except minor disruptions due to shortage of labor and trucks. I am pleased to share with you that during 2021, your company has registered profit before tax of 343.46 crore. As against loss before tax, rupees 252.71 crore during CPLY. PBT has increased mainly due to increase in contribution from urea, increase in profit from traded goods, industrial products and bentonite sulfur, reimbursement of one-time conversion cost of ammonia feedstock changeover project, and reduction in finance cost. Your company has achieved total income of 11,939 crore during 2021, as against 13,192.76 crore during previous year. The average gas price for own manufactured urea has reduced as compared to the previous year. During the year, there has been an increase of almost 10% in sale of own manufactured urea. The company sold 39.65 lakh metric ton of own manufactured urea as against 36.08 lakh metric ton in the previous year. The company has achieved urea production of 37.99 lakh metric ton with an overall capacity utilization of 117.58% during 2021 against previous year production of 37.27 lakh metric ton achieved during 2019-20. Your company has achieved ever best sale of fertilizers to the tune of 59.37 lakh metric ton against last year's sale of 57.03 lakh metric ton, thus exhibiting higher sale by 4.10% as compared to the previous year. Your company has achieved the ever best production and sale of certified seeds to the tune of 1.85 lakh quintals during the year under its flagship seed multiplication program started in the year 2015. The company has already commissioned the seed processing plants at Bathinda and Panipat during February and August 2020, respectively. While at Indore, the work of setting up seed processing plant is underway. The total seed processing capacity of the company after commissioning of all the three plants would be 1.20 lakh quintals per annum. Your company is also endeavoring to expand domestic trading of agro products. During the year, the company has registered total revenue of rupees 90.98 crore towards trading of various agro products compared to rupees 66 crore in the previous year. Your company is also setting up agrochemical manufacturing plant at Bathinda, which is likely to start production this year. The sale of industrial products also increased by 23% at rupees 243.33 crore during 2021 against rupees 170.45 crore in previous year. This is another area where your company is gearing up for growth in future by augmenting production and further plans to diversify into agriculture value chain and industrial chemicals. As you know, your company has maintained the momentum of the operations during the lockdown triggered by COVID-19 in close liaison with different government agencies. All the plants of the company worked continuously by maintaining the COVID protocols and thus achieved overall capacity utilization of 117.58% during 2021. To achieve targeted energy norms under new urea policy 2015, NFL is installing GTG HRSG projects at Bathinda, Panipat and Nangal units at a total cost of rupees 675 crore. Also, various energy saving schemes are being implemented at Vijaypur complex at a cost of rupees 235 crores. Energy saving project at Bathinda and Nangal has started its commercial operation in the month of May 21. Commissioning of project at Panipat unit was delayed due to COVID-related restrictions. It is, however, likely to be completed by the end of the year. Similarly, part of the schemes for energy reduction has been implemented in October 2020 for Vijaypur 1, and the remaining are expected to be completed by the end of the year. To meet the funding requirement for energy saving and CAPEX schemes, your company has entered into rupee term loan agreement with SBI on 24th December 2018 for rupees 1,000. 44 crores. It is a matter of relief for the company that Government of India had recently approved policy for providing increased fixed cost of rupees 350 per ton of urea and special compensation of rupees 150 per ton of urea as vintage allowance to more than 30-year-old gas-based plants. However, government has yet to consider the issue of minimum fixed cost of rupees 2300 per ton of urea for our Vijaypur 1 plant. As of now, there was no disinvestment of Government of India shareholding during the financial year 2021. However, Department of Investment and Public Asset Management, DIPAM, Ministry of Finance, Government of India had intimated regarding engagement of legal advisors, merchant bankers, and selling brokers for the disinvestment of 20% paid up equity capital in your company out of Government of India's shareholding through the offer for sale by promoters through the stock exchanges. Recently, your company signed MOU with fertilizer major IFFCO for transfer of technology of nano urea. Under the agreement, IFFCO will transfer the technology of nano urea to NFL. It is envisaged that in the near future, NFL may also establish nano urea production plant for increased availability of nano urea to the farmers of the country. Your company's commitment towards environment and safety has been applauded during the year by various organizations of repute. Our Nangal unit has received 3 awards for outstanding achievement in environment protection, and Vijaypur unit has also received Green Tech Environment Award 2020. On the safety front, Vijaypur, Panipat, and Bathinda units have won coveted safety awards from National Safety Council of India for their good performance in occupational health and safety. Your company is consistently working for upliftment of farming community through its various programs. Even after many COVID-related constraints, training programs were organized to educate farmers about balanced use of fertilizers, soil analysis, new farming technologies, methodology of application of different fertilizers, etc. Throughout the year, demonstrations had been laid out at farmers' fields to demonstrate benefits of use of biofertilizers, city compost, and bentonite sulfur, respectively, on crop growth and yield as compared to the farmers' own practices. Your company is playing a vital role in supporting farmers by undertaking soil analysis for macro and micronutrients through its 6 static and 5 mobile soil testing labs in various states. During the year, more than 23,000 soil samples were analyzed for macro and micronutrients, and recommendations were given to the farmers. Your company is constantly working towards inclusive growth in society through its CSR programs. Company is supporting underprivileged sections of the society through its CSR programs in the areas of health, education, skill development, environment, and empowerment of youth. To strengthen the medical infrastructure in underdeveloped districts, the company provided advanced life support ambulances in government hospitals in Basti and Sultanpur in Uttar Pradesh. The company also provided medical equipment in the district hospital Basti, Uttar Pradesh. To strengthen the government's efforts to control the COVID-19 pandemic in the country, the company provided cold chain equipments for storage of vaccine in Chandigarh to support the government's COVID-19 vaccination program. Your company has already installed 4 oxygen plants in Gorakhpur, Lucknow, Bhopal, and Indore. The company is also installing such oxygen plants in 3 more government hospitals in Noida, Bathinda, and Panipat. The philosophy of your company on corporate governance is to ensure transparency, disclosures, and reporting that conforms fully with the laws and regulations of the country. In order to promote ethical conduct and practices throughout the organization for enhancing stakeholders' value, your company is committed to comply with the provisions of SEBI relating to corporate governance and the guidelines on corporate governance for central public sector enterprises issued by Department of Public Enterprises, Government of India. As we continue our eventful journey, I express my gratitude for your continued support and faith in our endeavors. I also take this opportunity to sincerely thank and appreciate my colleagues on the board of directors for their valuable guidance and support in running the affairs of the company. I also wish to express my thanks to the Department of Fertilizers, Fertilizer Industry Coordination Committee, Department of Public Enterprises, Railways, other ministries, and departments of the Government of India and the various state governments for their valuable guidance, and look forward to their continued support. I would like to thank statutory, secretarial, cost and government auditors, banks, regulatory authorities for their guidance and support. I sincerely thank all our customers and business associates for their continued support. I would also like to thank all our employees for their commitment, hard work, and contribution to the company's performance. With the trust and confidence shown by all of you, we are looking forward to continue our journey in a manner that develops trust and enhances the long-term value for all stakeholders. Thank you. The company has taken all requisite steps to enable its members to participate and vote in the items as set out in notice of annual general meeting. I would like to announce that the statutory registers, including the register of directors and key managerial personnel, a register of contracts or arrangements, and other documents required to be made available at the AGM under the provisions of Companies Act 2013 are available for inspection through electronic mode. With your permission, I would like to take the notice of AGM along with board report, auditor's report, other documents and addendum to annual report circulated to the members as read, which is also available on the company's website as well as on the website of National Securities Depository Limited and on the websites of stock exchanges, that is National Stock Exchange of India Limited and BSE Limited. Now, I request the company secretary to inform the shareholders about auditors' observations or comments.
Thank you, sir. Statutory auditors of the company, Messrs. Mehra Goyal and Company and Messrs. Arun K. Agarwal and Associates, Chartered Accountants, in their independent auditor's report on audited financial statements, including consolidated financial statements for the year ended 31st March 2021, have not made any qualifications. Their report is unqualified. The Comptroller and Auditor General of India, under Section 143, Subsection 6, Subclause B of the Companies Act 2013, has made nil comments on the audited financial statements, standalone and consolidated, of the company for the financial year ended 31st March 2021. Comments of CNAG has been already circulated to the members and uploaded on the company's website. Comments of Messrs. Praveen Rastogi and Company, practicing company secretaries, in their report on compliance certificate on corporate governance and secretarial audit report, along with secretarial compliance report with management's explanation thereon, can be referred on page number 81 to 85 and page number 105 to 115 of the annual report, respectively. With your permission, I would like to take the same as read. Those members who want to inspect the statutory register kept open for inspection may kindly call at the phone number 0120-241-2322 for inspection. Now, I request the chairman to take up the meeting further.
Items of business to be transacted in 47th AGM have already been received by you. Item number 1 to 4 of the notice are in the nature of ordinary business, and item number 5 is special business. The resolutions, objective and implication are in the best interest of the company. I request the company secretary to read out the items of business set out in the notice.
I would like to read out the items as set out in the AGM notice. A total of 5 items have been proposed for approval of the members. Ordinary businesses. Number 1, to receive, consider and adopt the audited financial statements, including consolidated financial statement of the company for the financial year ended 31st March 2021, together with the board's report and auditor's report thereon and comments of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India in terms of Section 143(6) of the Companies Act 2013. Number 2, to appoint a director in place of Sri Viren Nagar, who retires by rotation at this annual general meeting and being eligible offers himself for reappointment. Third, to appoint a director in place of Sri Nirlep Singh Rai, who retires by rotation at this annual general meeting and being eligible offers himself for reappointment. Number four, to authorize the board of directors of the company to fix the remuneration of statutory auditors of the company in terms of the provisions of section 142(1) of the Companies Act 2013. Special business. Fifth, to ratify the remuneration of cost auditors for the financial year ended 31st March 2020. Now, I request the chairman to take up the meeting further.
I shall be glad to answer the queries, if any, on the items of the agenda which members wishes to raise. Now I request CS to initiate the process of question and answer session.
Now I will invite speaker shareholders who have registered themselves with the company as such in advance to ask their questions. Before we go live with the question and answer session, here are some points to note in order to be able to run the AGM in an efficient manner and with a view to address maximum questions from shareholders. Each registered shareholder will have 2 minutes to speak and ask their questions. If there is any connectivity issue at the speaker shareholder's end, we will request the next speaker shareholder to join the meeting and he will be requested to join later. To avoid repetition, questions will be addressed after hearing all speaker shareholders. I would request each one of you, as I call out your name, to please switch off your mobile phones in advance so that there is no disturbance in the background. Please state your complete name and your DP ID, client ID before you ask your question. I shall now invite the first shareholder speaker who has registered with us to ask the questions. Mr. Sanjeev Kumar Prajapati.
Sir, Sanjeev Kumar Prajapati, sir, ne join nahi kiya.
Next, Mr. Yashpal Chopra.
Yep. Sir, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Okay. To begin with, I must welcome our chairman, Sardar Nirlep Singh Ji. I wish him best of luck and I welcome him in our company. Let his entry in our company should be blissful for our CMD, as well as for the company, as well as for the investors. This is my prayer to the God, and I wish him a successful journey in our NF year. So further, I congratulate the entire body and board of eminent directors, because they have just our company has given an excellent performance this year in spite of a very, very harsh COVID time, whereas most of the companies have just given a very performance, or rather no performance, but our company has given excellent performance. So this is a matter of achievement, and that shows the dedication of our employees and the wisdom of our directors who have led the show. So, but sir, the coming time is definitely bright, because now their fear of corona is receding, and even our government, our prime minister, is just giving so many initiatives, and his dream of doubling the income of our farmers, that will be supplemented by our company, because our company is the products of our company are the basic what you call a foundation of the farmers' growth. You see that without this urea and all that, farmer cannot get a better crop and all that. So I feel that the next year, or the current year performance, that will be quite excellent, and it may be possible that company may declare dividend also for the investor. So I feel that way. Further, that I have just I have not much of query because the company is doing excellently well, but at the same time I would like to find out the status of our that nano project, because I am under the impression that that may the production may coming may start at that project in this year. But whatever it is, I just want to listen from sir your mouth as to where we have reached. And sir, and during corona period you have our company has done fantastic job, not only for our employees but even for the society around our plants and all that. They have just given the best possible humane service whichever is possible. So before I compliment, I must thank our company secretary Mr. Ashok, as well as our CFO Yashpal ji, because he is my hum name, somehow, for getting me a chance to speak in this this organization with which I am associated for a very very long time. So my I am interested in the growth of my investment, and that is why I am with the company. I am with a hopeful note. Even the price of the share has risen very much this year, and that shows the strength of the company and the strength of the project and the strength of the future. So before I close, I pray God to bestow positivity on you all from the top to the last man in the project, so that that is the strength of our, that will be the strength of our company, and the strength of the company will be the strength of my investment. Best of luck. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Next speaker, Mr. Gyaneshwar Kumar Verma.
मेरा नाम गणेश्वर कुमार वर्मा है. मेरा डीपी क्लाइंट आईडी है 1204720027125300. सबसे पहले सर मैं आपका तहे दिल से धन्यवाद करता हूं कि आपने मुझे प्रश्न करने का मौका दिया. सीएमडी सर, मैं आपसे ये पूछना चाहता हूं कि इतने अच्छे परिणामों के बावजूद भी कंपनी ने इस पर कोई भी डिविडेंड क्यों नहीं दिया. धन्यवाद.
ओके, थैंक यू. Next speaker, Mr. Anurag Rathi.
Good afternoon. मेरा नाम अनुराग राठी है. मेरा DP ID 1202060 और client ID 01200848 है. मेरा आपसे ये प्रश्न है कि RFCL project का अभी क्या status है और आने वाले समय में इससे हमारी company को क्या-क्या फायदा होगा? Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Next speaker, Mr. Jasmeet Singh.
सर जसमीत सिंह जी अभी है नहीं मीटिंग में, अपने एक्सपर्ट.
अच्छा, मिस भारती ग्रोवर. मिस भारती ग्रोवर,
गुड आफ्टरनून. आई एम भारती ग्रोवर. माय डीपी क्लाइंट आईडी.
यस प्लीज गो अहेड.
My DP client ID is 1204470007235180. I would just like to congratulate all of you for doing a great job for the company, especially CMD sir, under whose leadership NFL is achieving a new chapter of success. I believe management would continue to perform in this way. I'm a shareholder of the company for a very long time, and thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to speak in the 47th AGM of NFL. I wish to know, Chairman sir, what is the reason for decrease in turnover of the company from rupees 13135.36 crore to rupees 11905.66 crore? Thanks to all of you.
Thank you.
Next. Sir, Mr. Jasmeet aa gaye hain, main unko reply kar
raha hoon. Ha, please Mr. Jasmeet Singh.
Yeah,
yes sir, please.
Yeah, am I audible and visible?
Yes sir, please sir, go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for your confirmation, appreciate. Dear chairman Nirlep ji, director technical Virendra Nath ji, director finance Yashpal Bhola ji, other directors, company secretary Shri Ashok Jha and Nirbhay, and everyone attending this AGM, greetings to you all from Jasmeet Singh. Chairman sir, the working shared by you about our company has provided us fair amount of information. I am sure with your guidance and due diligence, our company will do very well in future. I have confidence in our core business team who would have been and will continue to work hard even in these pandemic times to deliver much better numbers and achieve new milestones in the coming quarters and years. So I am afraid that I don't have any questions to ask the board pertaining to our accounts or balance sheet. However, Chair, I do have a couple of concerns which I would like to share with you and the management. In this regard, Chair, to make this session more interactive and useful, I will request if you can kindly respond me on my concerns on the spot, such that on your given responses, if I need any clarification, I may ask you here and here itself. And I would like to request the moderator not to mute me in between until I finish. Let me share my first concern with you, which is with regard to safety of our employees. While I am sure most of the employees would have got vaccinated by now, there I would like to know that are we following all compliances with regard to safety of especially all the women employees, be it permanent or on contractual basis, working in our company in these unusual times, especially when the mass culture has become a new normal. I hope that the post trainings are conducted regularly. If not, I will request head HR to prioritize this. By the way, what is the gender ratio that we presently have in our company? Chair, if you can give your inputs now.
Yeah, Mr. Jasmeet, good afternoon to you, and thank you very much for reposing confidence in the management of the company for performing excellently during the times of COVID. Your concern regarding safety and vaccination and the women employees is appreciated. The vaccination drive is on at all the units, and most of the employees have already been vaccinated.
Great.
So we have given a prioritized thrust to all the units to get the employees vaccinated first, and at the same time encourage all the employees to get their families also vaccinated as soon as possible.
So great.
The entire progress is being monitored on daily basis by our respective HR units, and it is soon we'll be through with 100% vaccination for employees and their family members. As regards the security and safety of women employees, NFL is following the guidelines and also taking care of their duty timings and providing them with adequate security and cover if that is required to be done at any time. Regarding the gender ratio, I do not have the exact figure with me. I'm sure we'll get back to you on this about gender ratio.
6%.
Yeah, Chairman, sir, if you can kindly also look into the training part, so that will be great. Now, let me move on to the second concern, which is with regard to the CSR. So I draw the attention to our CSR committee members on the following point. Having read the annual report, I praise the efforts of our company to contribute its bit to the society, especially during the COVID. As per the government national policy on CSR, the focus needs to be on health, education, and skill development, which we also need to follow. My concern is that in case we are not following this very order of priority, which we should, so that's my concern. And by the way, I am also closely working with an NGO promoting both education and health. And so subsequent to this annual body meet, I would like to get introduced to the IGL CSR team to explore common grounds to work together. May I request for your inputs on this, please?
Jasmeet ji, we are just taking questions, then we will let you know at the end of the session, because we are
all right. All right. So let me continue and finish my note quickly now. Okay, thank you.
Please.
Yeah. I have my concern with regard to business also. the continued and the intensifying agitation by the protesting farmers against the three farmers bill, how far we are impacted and what are the measures that we are taking to mitigate the risk out of this continued stalemate? Another question, the input costs, including transportation cost, are rapidly increasing. So are we passing this onto the into the pricing of our product, or are we absorbing it and settle with the lower margins? Please clarify. Okay. So to finish, before I finish my note, it would be unfair without praising the high standards of corporate governance. I am sure our respective finance team led by Shri Bhola ji and secretarial team led by Ashok ji will continue to keep high standards. Finally, on a very personal note, it was a surprise to me as I came to know that Shri Rakesh Gogia ji, Manoj ji, Rajkumar ji, which were the pillars, have all got retired in quick succession. While our company nurtured the soil, they nurtured our company. I would like to convey my gratitude to all of them. I hope they will continue to give consultancy to our company to keep it growing. To close, I wish everyone all the very best. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Next speaker, Mr. Shivin Gupta.
Hello.
Yes, please go ahead.
My company ka share dharak bahut din.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yes sir, mera DPID client ID hai 12047200340613 7. Se pehle main company ke naye CMD ko badhai de aur ummeed karta hu ki unke netritv mein company nayi unchaiyon ko chhegi aur behtar se behtar padegi. Mera prashn ye hai ki nano ya project ki jo NFL ne ki se company ko aane wale kya fayda hoga. Dhanyawad.
Okay, thank you. Next speaker, Mr. Tony Bhatia.
Yes, sir, meri awaaz aa rahi hai?
Haan sir, aa rahi hai, please go ahead. Yes sir, please go ahead.
Okay sir, thank you chairman sir. Respected chairman sir, board of directors aur mere shareholders friend. Sabse pehle main chairman sir tuhanu welcome karda, ji aaya nu aakda as a chairman. Aapne sir, you gave us such a beautiful chairman speech. Usse hamare kafi points clear ho gaye hain. I am sure with God grace, our company has got a very, very bright future. I am going to take a few lines in this regard accounts. PBT 343.46 crores against 252.71 crores. PAT 249.63 crores against 171.0 crores. There is a total comprehensive income 250.50 crores against 196.31 crores. I am happy to know that our company is a leading Indian company in fertilizers and beyond with this commitment to all stakeholders. The company has achieved ever best sale of fertilizer to the tune of 59.37 LMT, comprising 39.65 LMT. I am happy to note that this was a hat-trick year of our company. Sale of fertilizer was more than sale of all other fertilizers PSU put together during the year. Such a good sign, Mr. Chairman. I appreciate it. Our company is constantly working towards changing the business strategy to diversify its products range. Company is going on the right track, Mr. Chairman. Corporate governance, you have shown in such a good manner. For this, credit goes to our CFO, company secretary, and other secretarial department, respected Yashpal ji, Ashok ji, and other secretarial department. CSR activities पे आपने काफी ध्यान दिया, इसके लिए मैं आपकी तारीफ करूंगा चेयरमैन साहब. Awards and achievements, our company got 100 awards achievements. Sir, such a good sign, Mr. Chairman. ये आपकी पूरे बोर्ड की सब एम्प्लॉइज की इसमें तारीफ होगी, जिनकी कड़ी मेहनत की वजह से टुडे आज हमारी कंपनी को 100 अवार्ड्स मिले हैं. मैं कंपनी सेक्रेटरी जी का, सेक्रेटरियल डिपार्टमेंट जी का, उनका, लोगों का शुक्रिया अदा करूंगा कि उन्होंने ये बीसी ओवीएम मीटिंग आज अरेंज कराई, उनका मैं शुक्रिया अदा करूंगा। 11 वक्त में चेयरमैन साहब ना लेते हुए आपका एक बार फिर मैं आई सपोर्ट एंड सेकॉर्डेड द बैलेंस शीट। आई एम 100% श्योर विद गॉड ग्रेस अवर कंपनी हैव गॉट ए ब्राइट फ्यूचर। With these words, I support and second in the balance sheet. Khuda humare chairman saab ko lambi umar de, salamat rakhe, khushiyan de. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, sir.
Okay, ji. Thank you. Next speaker, Mr. Jasmer Singh. Mr. Jasmer Singh.
Awaaz aa rahi hai meri?
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Namaskar, sir. मेरा नाम जसमेर सिंह है। मेरा DPID क्लाइंट आईडी 12047900008668 है। मैं कंपनी को मुबारकबाद देना चाहूँगा क्योंकि कंपनी ने वित्त वर्ष 2020-21 में भी अच्छे परिणाम घोषित किए हैं। सर, मेरा प्रश्न यह है कि कंपनी की फाइनेंस कॉस्ट इस वर्ष पिछले वर्ष की तुलना में कम कैसे रही? धन्यवाद सर।
ओके जी, थैंक यू। नेक्स्ट स्पीकर मिस्टर संजीव कुमार पुरोहित।
हेलो
हेलो, यस सर, प्लीज गो अहेड।
हेलो, हाँ सर, मैं संजीव पुरोहित बोल रहा हूँ। मेरा DPID नंबर IN30154939633223 है। मैं कंपनी सेक्रेटरी मिस्टर अशोक झा एवं उनकी टीम का सराहना करता हूं कि जिन्होंने कोरोना पीरियड में भी कंपनी के रूटीन वर्किंग और जो कंपनी जिन प्रोजेक्ट में काम कर रही है उसकी जानकारी शेयर होल्डर्स को दी, जिससे कि कहते हैं ये कंपनी की तरफ से शेयर होल्डर्स को अपनी सारी जानकारी पहुंचाने के लिए जो तत्पर है उसकी मैं प्रशंसा करता हूं। धन्यवाद सर।
ओके जी, थैंक यू। नेक्स्ट स्पीकर मिस्टर मुरली।
सर, मिस्टर मुरली ने ज्वाइन नहीं किया।
ओके, नेक्स्ट स्पीकर मिस्टर अजय कुमार जैन।
अजय जी ने भी ज्वाइन नहीं किया।
ठीक है, दैट्स ऑल।
So the first question is by Mr. Yashpal Chopra. First of all, thank you very much, Mr. Yashpal Chopra, for wishing well to the company and keeping the company in your prayers. You have asked that what is the status of Nano project and when is the production likely to start? See, we have signed the MOU with the IFFCO for transfer of technology, and right now we are working on preparation of a TFR, techno-economic feasibility report, for the project. And once the TFR is out, so depending upon the viability, we will start working on the project. And as per the feedback from IFFCO, it approximately takes about 18 to 19 months to set up a plant. I hope that answers your query. Thank you. Mr. Ganeshwar has inquired about that why the company did not pay dividend for this year. So Mr. Ganeshwar, you are aware that your company has been very consistent in payment of dividends throughout. However, in view of the requirement of funds in various capex schemes lined up by the company has requested DIPAM through Department of Fertilizers for exemption from payment of minimum dividend for the year 2021. The capex schemes that I mentioned includes further energy saving scheme at Nangal, Panipat and Bathinda, and energy saving schemes at Vijaypur 1 and Vijaypur 2, and the revival of the second stream of nitric acid plant at Nangal unit to revamp our industrial products portfolio, investments foreseen in the Nano Urea project, and the likelihood of equity participation in Namroop 4 project. So, and other commitments are that, repayment of SBI long-term loan of rupees 104 crores on annual basis. Keeping in view the guidelines issued by Government of India and availability of profit in the coming years, the company might be in a position to declare dividends in future. I hope that answers your query, Mr. Gyaneshwar. Then the next query is by Mr. Anurag Rathi. He is inquiring about the status of RFCL project. Mr. Rathi, as you are aware that this plant is being set up by NFL, EIL and FCIL, with NFL and EIL having equity stake of 26% and FCIL of 11%. You must be aware that the plant was commissioned on 22nd March 2021. Thereafter, the plant came into operation, and the capacity and the load of the plant is now gradually being ramped up after, you know, slight issues that were faced during the commissioning of the plant. You also must be aware that NFL has the marketing rights to sell 100% of urea produced from Ramagundam Fertilizers and Chemicals Limited, and NFL will get a margin of 140 rupees per ton of urea. Also, NFL has a manpower management consultancy arrangement with Ramagundam Fertilizers and Chemicals Limited. So NFL is now leveraging its experience in fertilizer, especially urea marketing, in the southern part of the country. And now we have a very firm stronghold in the southern part of the country, especially the main catchment area of RFCL. And with this, now we are truly a pan-India company. I hope that answers your query, Mr. Anurag Rathi. Then the next question was the leftover part of Mr. Jasmeet Singh's question. Gender ratio, Mr. Jasmeet, is approximately 6% currently. And the CSR activities, you said that the health, skill and education must be the priority. Yes, indeed they are. And like, we are going to schools and construction of toilets, making skill development programs, installing solar lights in villages, organizing medical camps for the health issues in villages, support to the para players, soil and water testing labs, and also contributing to the flood relief funds for Assam and the PM CARES fund for COVID affected areas. Regarding the farmers' bills and the protests going on, really it doesn't have any impact on the operations of the company. And regarding the input cost and the transportation cost, I would request our director of marketing to take the query, please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Regarding the input costs and basically we can divide them in two parts. One is the cost of producing the urea, which is largely centered around cost of gas, which is reimbursed through the subsidy to the company. As regards the supply and distribution costs, the company keeps a very close eye on the expenses being incurred under various activities like transportation, warehousing, handling, etc., so that the charges are kept at bare minimum. And I'm happy to inform that for the year, our charges have been below the budgeted figure, and we have performed quite creditably. Apart from that, there are, of course, certain aspects on which we are dependent on the government, where the government gives us a reimbursement of secondary freight for transportation of fertilizer from the rake points to the market. That there is usually a lag between the time the government decides the reimbursement values and the time, because we incur it in advance. But we have already taken up the matter, and the Department of Fertilizers is seized of the issue. And as in the past, this will also get resolved as we go along. So largely, we keep a very keen eye on keeping the costs under control, so that our distribution costs are bare minimum and our contribution to the profits is maintained. Thank you.
पहले से अगला सवाल था शिवेन गुप्ता जी का कि नैनो से फायदा क्या है. इट्स इंडीड अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन मिस्टर शिवेन. नैनो इज सीन एज अ मेजर डिसरप्शन इन द यूरिया एप्लीकेशन इंडस्ट्री. जो इफको से डेटा हमारे पास है उससे यह बताया जाता है कि नैनो का जो फर्टिलाइजर यूज एफिशिएंसी है वो लगभग 80% के आसपास है, जो कि यूरिया का जो यूज एफिशिएंसी है उससे लगभग दुगना है. तो इससे एक फायदा तो ये होगा कि इससे जो कम क्वांटिटी में ही जितनी नाइट्रोजन एक पौधे को चाहिए वो पौधे तक पहुंच जाएगी. दूसरा है कि जो यूरिया एक बैग में जैसे 45 केजी बैग में आती है तो नैनो जो है वो आधा लीटर बॉटल में आती है. आधा लीटर बॉटल की जो नाइट्रोजन पोटेंसी है वो जो एक 45 केजी बैग में नाइट्रोजन है उसके बराबर है. तो इसके चलते हुए जो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कॉस्ट है और जो कॉस्ट टू द फार्मर है वो भी कम रहेगी, क्योंकि ये जो एक इसकी जो कॉस्ट है वो भी 10-15% कम बताई जा रही है एज कंपेयर टू द कॉस्ट ऑफ द कन्वेंशनल यूरिया. तो इन चीज़ों के साथ जो फार्मर के जो खर्चे हैं, यूरिया को अप्लाई करना, इसको स्टोर करना, इसको खरीदना, इस सभी के साथ जो फार्मर का जो एक्सपेंस है वो कम होगा. और जो एक एम है गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का कि फार्मर की जो इनकम को डबल करना, ये उसमें भी सहाई होगा जो नैनो फर्टिलाइजर का ये वाला जो पार्ट है. मैक्रो स्केल पे अगर बात करें तो नैनो का जो पोटेंशियल बताया जा रहा है कि ये 50% यूरिया को रिप्लेस करने की इसमें क्षमता है. तो अगर इफ दैट यू नो ऑल्सो कम्स ट्रू, देन जो आपका फर्टिलाइजर इंपोर्ट कर रहे हैं हम बहुत ज़्यादा, जैसे लास्ट ईयर हमने अप्रॉक्सीमेटली अपनी जितनी फर्टिलाइजर इंडिया में प्रोड्यूस करी उसका लगभग 37% हमने इम्पोर्ट किया, तो इसका इम्पोर्ट के ऊपर भी काफ़ी प्रभाव होगा. सो ये जो अभी तक के जो गैदर डेटा है अबाउट द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ नैनो, दिस इज व्हाट आई हैव शेयर्ड विद यू एंड आई होप के इससे आपके जो सवाल का जवाब है आपको मिल गया होगा. थैंक यू मिस्टर शिवन. अगला सवाल है मिस्टर जसमेर सिंह का कि इस साल हमारा फाइनेंस कॉस्ट कम क्यों है. जसमेर सिंह जी, इस साल का जो हमारा फाइनेंस कॉस्ट कम होने के मेजरली दो कारण हैं. एक तो जो गवर्नमेंट ने 2020-21 में एडिशनल प्रावधान किया सब्सिडी का, विच वॉज टू द ट्यून ऑफ 65,000 करोड़ रुपए, उससे जो सब्सिडी एरियस थे वो डिसबर्स हो गए इंडस्ट्री को, उससे जो हमारा जो कंपनी को फायदा हुआ. और दूसरा जो है उससे हमारी जो बोरोइंग्स है वो कम हो गई. सेकेंड इज के जो इस साल में जो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स रहे वो भी कम रहे. सो इन दोनों चीज़ों से हमारा जो फाइनेंस कॉस्ट है वो प्रीवियस ईयर के मुकाबले में कम रही. तो आई होप दैट आंसर्स योर क्वेरी मिस्टर जसमेर सिंह. अगला सवाल है श्रीमती भारती ग्रोवर का. इन्होंने पूछा है कि डिक्रीज इन टर्नओवर ऑफ द कंपनी फ्रॉम रुपीज 13,135 करोड़ टू 11,905 करोड़. मिस भारती, एज यू आर अवेयर दैट मेजर कंपोनेंट ऑफ कॉस्ट ऑफ यूरिया इज द गैस विच इज द रॉ मटेरियल एज वेल एज द फ्यूल. तो जो 2020-21 में गैस के रेट्स रहे वो प्रीवियस ईयर के मुकाबले में लगभग 27% डाउन रहे. 2021 में गैस रही अप्रॉक्सीमेटली $8.8 पर MMBTU, जबकि उससे प्रीवियस ईयर में ये गैस का प्राइस रही $11.95 पर MMBTU. सो मेन कारण जो हमारा टर्नओवर कम होने का यही है. एट द सेम टाइम ये टर्नओवर कम है लेकिन इस साल हमने लगभग 67,000 टन्स यूरिया एडिशनल बनाया एज कंपेयर टू द प्रीवियस ईयर. सो आई होप दिस आंसर्स योर क्वेरी मिस भारती ग्रोवर. Now I request CS to initiate the process. This is over. The company has provided the e-voting facility during the AGM for members who have not voted through remote e-voting and who are present at the AGM. As the meeting is convened through video conferencing or other audio-visual means today, resolutions have already been put to vote through remote e-voting and the requirement to propose and second is not applicable. Shri Pramod Kothari of Messrs. Pramod Kothari and Company, Company Secretaries, has been appointed as scrutinizer to scrutinize the remote e-voting and e-voting at the AGM. The e-voting facility is available in the e-voting platform of the NSDL. The e-voting facility would close after 15 minutes from the conclusion of this AGM. As already informed, the e-voting shall remain open for 15 minutes after the conclusion of AGM. The results of the e-voting will be informed to the stock exchanges and will be posted on the website of the company and NSDL within a period of 2 working days of conclusion of the AGM. I declare that the meeting stands concluded and I once again thank each one of you for your attendance through video conferencing or other audio visual means and cooperation. I wish the shareholders all the very best. Good health and staying safe in the current environment is very important. I wish that we together with the rest of the world get over the COVID-19 pandemic soon and hope to meet you in person at the next AGM. I hope you will also excuse the inconvenience and any other glitches, if any, you might have faced in the virtual AGM. I now declare the meeting as closed. Thank you all. Jai Hind.
Now I request Sri Yashpal Bulla, Director of Finance and CFO of the company, to give his vote of thanks to the shareholders.
It is with pleasure that I rise to propose a vote of thanks at this 47th Annual General Meeting of NFL. I express my sincere thanks to Shri Nirlep Singh Rai, CNMD, all the directors, President's nominee Shri Anil Fulwari, members attending this meeting through video conferencing or other audio-video means, auditors, secretarial auditor, scrutinizer, NFL employees, and others who have contributed to make this meeting a success. Thank you.
Thank you very much.